good. And then, so my favorite dog to talk about is this fancy little dog, and she is so adorable, but you can tell that she was raised rich. Like, even though she's a dog, she has a nice life and she knows it. So this dog lives in the apartments along Central Park, and for those of you that do not know New York City, like, the Central Park apartments are prime real estate, and I cannot tell you how much they cost, but I can tell you that you have to be banking it big time to afford to live in one of those places. Like, this is one of those places where I went in and I said, "Hey, I'm here to walk this dog." Now, with every other dog that I have walked, there is usually the lockbox, the WAG lockbox, and the owner puts the keys in the lockbox, and you just have the code, and you take the keys out, and that's how you get into the building, and that's how you get into the actual apartment. Or with two of the locations, there were doormen, but the doorman knew that you were coming, and so they would just give you the keys, and you still went up to the apartment yourself. So you're going into these, you know, these people are trusting you to go into their home and just get the dog, do it. Like, if you need to feed them or whatever, you feed them, and then you just go on this walk, and you come back, and you know, you don't touch anything. Like, they're trusting you at that. So this is one of those places where it does not work like that at all. So I show up to my first day to pick up this dog, and I say, "Hey, I'm the dog walker. I'm here to walk the dog in this apartment." And they're like, "Okay, go through that door." I'm like, "All right." So they're like, "Go through that door. The elevator's through there." So I open this door, and it's like this really crappy hallway. And I'm just like, well, like, the lobby may be nice, but even if you're banking it, you're kind of have like these crappy situations. And then I get to the elevator, and it's also really crappy. And I'm just like, why would you have like such a crappy elevator and like such a crappy hallway? And then we go in, I go in, and there's a guy in the elevator who takes me up the elevator to the apartment, and he basically is there to like make sure I pick up the dog and then get back in the elevator, and then he takes me back down. So like, at no point was I alone except to like walk into this hallway, but it's such a crappy hallway. What am I gonna do in that hallway? But anyway, we get to the floor, and like, the door's open. I'm like, what is like with these crap? Like, why does everything look so crappy? And then that's when it hits me, and I'm like, oh, I'm in the service elevator, the service hallways. Like, this is how rich they are that me and these people, the service people that work there, are like so not dignified to walk through the same hallways and the same doorways that they walk, and like use the same hallways and the same elevators that they walk through. Like, we have to use the crappy ones, and only their rich little selves have access to these things. So that tells you how rich they are. I'm not saying like there's anything necessarily wrong with that, but it was just like reality check, like major reality check. So I was like, oh, okay. So that's the kind of household this dog grew up in. And I said, like I said, she's like so adorable. Imagine like the kind of frou-frou kind of dog that is in this house, and that's what you're getting. So, yeah, I ring the doorbell and they give me this dog. And so whenever you have a dog, the owners give you notes, and then like all the other walkers that have walked this particular dog before give you notes as well, so you know how to handle these dogs. And so like everyone was like, this dog does not like going on walks. Just so you're aware, what you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to like pick her up, walk away from the apartment, and then put her down, because otherwise she's just gonna like keep trying to go back inside the apartment. So I was like, okay, well that's good to know. So this dog does not bark, she doesn't cry, she doesn't whine, she doesn't make any noise. But if she does not like something, she will let you know with the look. So when I picked her up and I walked away from the apartment, she literally looked at me like this the whole time. And I'm just like, the amount of sass in this dog is unbelievable. She is, I will continue to say it because it's true, she's the cutest little thing, but it's just like, how does such, like, you can just tell what kind of household you were raised in. Like, the amount of, like, sass in this tiny little body is unbelievable. And I ended up walking her again a few days later, and at one point so what she does is she like walks around the block and then she's done. If she's pooed and she's peed and we've walked around the block, she's done. Now this is like a really small like square, so that is like literally, we were at 12 minutes and they were paying me for a 30-minute walk, so I didn't want to like go drop her off after 12 minutes, especially because like the company itself gives you a hard time for ending a walk early. They're just like, well, why are you ending it early? Which, I mean, I get it, because these people are hiring you for a certain amount of time and you're getting paid to walk this dog for that amount of time. So I was like, I can't take you home yet because we need to keep walking. We still have 18 minutes left on this walk. Like, we have to finish walking those 18 minutes. And she just looks at me and she starts pulling on her leash, trying to go home, and I pick her up and I walk in the opposite direction and I put her down, and she keeps trying to like go back to the apartment, and I was trying to like, no, we have to keep like, you know, trying to assert myself as the leader and just being like, no, we're gonna keep walking. This dog, she sits down, her back facing me, and she literally did this. This is no joke. This is what she did. She flipped her head. She flipped her head at me, and again, I'm just like, okay, do not give me attitude, young lady. Like, tell your owners not to schedule you for a 30-minute walk if you don't want to walk 30 minutes. But we're going to finish this walk. It was a battle of me picking her up and walking and her pulling me back. Like I said, this dog doesn't cry. She doesn't whine. She doesn't bark. She looks at you with that look, and then she just like starts kicking, so you'll put her down on the floor. And So I had to, I, yeah.